Across Austria, Italy and 11 German states, heavily armed police launched coordinated pre-dawn raids, making 25 arrests. Authorities allege the conspirators, including ex-military personnel and a former far-right MP, were cooking up a coup.
According to our information, individual members of the terrorist group considered entering the German parliament by force.
The alleged coup plotters intended to form a new German army and install a minor aristocrat as the country's leader.
That's the man who would be king, 71-year-old Heinrich XIII, Prince Royce von Greiss.
The supposed ringleader of this network was this descendant of this noble family who is also an entrepreneur.
To be honest, I have no words. The government we have is not ideal, but probably better than what they had planned.
The plotters are part of the wider Reichsbürger movement, which roughly translates to citizens of the Reich. The loose movement is united on its rejection of the modern German state, which was formed after the collapse of the Nazi Reich in 1945. But while some of them simply don't like paying taxes, others hold violently racist and anti-Semitic beliefs.
Based on current findings, the suspected terrorist group uncovered today was founded based on coup d'etat fantasies and conspiracy ideologies.
And if all that feels a little familiar, it is.
Not least, the storming of the US Capitol after the last presidential election showed these people that there are options to destroy the state order.
And like their American counterparts, the pandemic's created some great recruitment opportunities.
It's a development which shows that right-wing extremism is moving from the margins to the centre. It's a very dangerous development.
Today, our Home Affairs Minister acknowledging that we are not immune.
A very large group of people who are of interest, who are subscribed to various forms of right-wing kind of nationalism, Nazism, those sorts of things, and it's obviously enormously concerning.
So as the far right rises, are we prepared to meet the threat?
I feel like that story took a turn because it just sounds like something that you're like, that's fantastical, that can't be a thing, it's absolutely nonsensical. And then you look into it and you're like, wait, hang on, they were being serious.
It's funny till it's not. Yes. It's one of those sort of stories.
Well, if it was anywhere but Germany, you'd almost have a laugh about it. But when you think about the history of Germany and what happened the last time a group like this got control of the country, you don't laugh about it at all.
But that's why it's significant, right? Because, the rise of that far right generally, but then the extremist wing of it all over the world, especially in the Western world. But the fact that it's in Germany is really significant because that's the one country it's not meant to happen, right? The conventional wisdom was always, will never happen in Germany because everyone remembers it. And now you're seeing that that's clearly not enough to hold. Mm. And what's fascinating about just watching the dynamics of it is it's all hyper-nationalist, but it's deeply globalised. They're just talking points are all taken from the United States.
That's what I was going to say.
It becomes a global community. And you throw a pandemic in and, well, it's hardly a surprise.
And we aren't immune from it here. We have seen, small sections of the community like that.
Totally.
Yeah.